Very good afternoon to all of you. I'm giving a view on real-time wave forecasting, which I've used using various soft computing tools like artificial neural network, model trees, and genetic programming. This wave analysis incorporates the procedure of estimating, calculating, and diagnosing wave conditions. And out of this, significant wave height is of immense importance. Traditionally, this forecasting was done using by transforming the wind information to wave information with various empirical equations like SMB, Hesselman, CM. For later, numerical models like WAM and SWAN came into existence. With the deployment of data voice around the country's coastline, various time series modeling using stochastic models like ARMA, ARIMA, and recently ANN came into were used. And these time series based models are very recent. I've applied, I've taken two sites, first from the Gulf of Mexico, which can be easily downloadable and exhaustive data is available, so I've chosen this site. Out of these, I've taken four sites, two from the deeper location and two from the shallow location. For the station 42001, I've taken a small data set, that is from the deeper location, and for the other three stations, I've taken an exhaustive set of 12 years early significant height data. Various innovative schemes have tried for input-output combinations where various training schemes, various algorithms to get the best model for the forecasting. When we go for lower lead time predictions, like for 3 hours, 6 hours, the predictions from all these models were quite comparable. But when we go for higher lead times, like 12 and 24 hours, like that, the results deteriorated, and up till now, so many trials have been done to improve these results. With the study, I found that a method in which previous selective hour values like 3rd, 6th, 12th, 24 I'm taking, and the predictions is one at a time, one lead hour, like 3rd hour at a time. So the model will be having four inputs, like previous 3rd, 6th, 12th, and 24th, and the output will be one, that is 12th, 24th, like that. So that I have named it, we give it as a jumping forecast method, and these are the results with various error measures of correlation coefficient, root mean square error, and mean absolute error. With this background, to the other three stations which I have taken for 12 years, the data was exhaustive. So first I did the statistical study and saw that quite a large variation is there in the data even between the months. So 12 month-wise networks were developed for each of the voice stations, that is 42036, 42003, and 42019. And again, various method, various iterations of the input-output combinations were done to improve the higher lead time results of 12th and 24th. Again, going through the data, we saw that there exists a lot of gaps in the data. This is a particular example of it. So we try to see how is the percentage of the missing values in the data. And we saw that the missing values varied from 6.57 to 42%. So it was felt to fill these gaps using some appropriate methods. This is quite logical, but this has not been applied to this wave data. So we tried to fill using some appropriate data, and we tried various methods available in the literature. Out of this, we found that temporal regression was applied to fill these gaps when the gaps were small, like for a week or a day. But when the gaps were high, we used the spatial mapping, that is, using the other station's data nearby to fill that data. And we can see a lot of improvement with the help of these error measures in the the correlation coefficient before and after the filling. This is for station 42003 and 42019. We can see the picture. The left hand side is for scatter plot and right hand side is the time series plot for 12th hour and 24th hour for station 42003 before filling the gaps. And we can see the improvement in the results when we fill the gaps earlier to the data before applying to the network. The picture would be more clear with the graph. These dotted lines are after filling of the gaps, and the full line is for before filling the gaps for 12th and 24th hour data. Again, the data mining tools like MT and GP were applied to see if the improvement in the large lead times could be possible. These are the results for the three stations with various error measures. The picture would be more clear, and when we see that all the three tools, that is ANN, MT and GP, are compared, when all three error measures are taken into account, we see that the MT, GP are working parallel or equal to ANN. So it would be dependent upon the choice of the user to use the tool. Again, we took a Indian data site, out of which this is the deeper location and these are the two shallow locations. The data set belonged to from year 1998 to 2004. And again, when we studied the data, we could see the gaps. And hence, these gaps were filled using temporal regression and spatial mapping according to the number of data gaps present. And using the jumping forecast method, we were able to get very good results. Even for 24 hour higher lead time results, the error measure, if we see the error measures, it is quite comparable to the lower lead time results, which has not been attained by any of the researcher till now. So we were able to, with these innovative schemes and applying other processing and all, we were able to get very good results. These are the scatter plots and time series plots for the stations of our 12th and 24th hour. Again, for when we got so good results for higher lead times, we tried to apply it for higher lead times of 48 and 72 hour, and we were able to get quite good results for these three stations. These are the time scatter plot and time series plot for the station SW4, for an example. Again, data mining tool of model tree was applied to these data, and these are the results for the three stations DS1, SW4 and SW2 with the various lead time hours. This is genetic programming was applied. A comparative comparison can be seen for the three tools, that is ANN, MT and GP, when these high lead time were taken. And we can see that they match each other when all the three errors are taken together. In all the forecasting, we saw that when it comes to peaks, there is a little deviation. So we try to improve the forecasting scheme using some hybrid models. In this hybrid model, we are taking the input data, and the for each of the lead time hour of 3, 6, 12 and 24, we are taking these output again as an input along with the observed values using ANN, and we get for higher lead time as an improved peak prediction model. For various lead times, the number of input changes accordingly. And with this scatter plot, we can see that the scatter reduces when we are using the hybrid model. This is for ANN model comparison for 12th and 24th. And this is for 48 and 72 hour. In case of 12th and 24th, the results were comparable, but when it comes to higher, it deteriorates. With all these model formed, we tried to integrate through a graphical user interface so that a user can use it. An IoT has deployed its buoys around the country's coastline and collects the wave information. This wave information they disseminate to various other users like port and harbor, other things. So this is the main window of the graphical user interface. In this, for all the sites, various models has been integrated. So the person who is there in NIoT has to just click the station in which he wants to get the forecasted data, load the previous 24 hours data and run. When he is clicking the run, the graphical user interface which we have developed takes care whether if the data is having any missing values. It fills it up using temporal regression or spatial mapping according to the number of gaps present, and then run the different models for 3, 6, 12 and 24 hour to get the forecast and give the forecast in the form of a graph or even the prediction values. And similarly, if he wants to go for the other stations, that is also integrated in the same graphical user interface. So with this, I'll come to the conclusion that various larger sample sizes necessary to get a better results from our study we have seen. And for very long duration data, monthly forecasting models could be a better choice. Also, a simple forward network using LM is good enough. And the best method for training we have found is jumping forecast method. Also, statistical homogeneity in the data helps infilling in of gaps in the measurements by appropriate methods certainly improves the results. For 24-hour lead time, it was had remained a difficult problem for several last years. So this has been successfully tackled in the Indian locations by innovative learning methods, and further by appropriately filling the gaps. However, it has a limitation that the wave values were in the range of 2.5 to 6 meters, means for higher values it deteriorates. And also applications of genetic programming and model trees were almost untried so far for ocean engineering problems and time series prediction in particular. So this has been applied for larger lead times, and they are attractive. And the choice may of a particular model should will be dependent upon the convenience. The use of technique of GP and MT is yet to be reported widely in ocean engineering, and this work indicates that they look very promising for the future applications. The advantage of having large number of controlling mathematical functions like ANN, and hence more flexibility in data mining and the built-in capacity to handle a large amount of data, are attractive features of GP as well as MT. The technology in terms of wave forecasting models developed in this study has been transferred for its actual implementation to Government of India's National Data Buoy Collection, namely NIOT. This is done by constructing a graphical user interface for online wave forecasting for the benefit of users. So this way we can make the application, and we can see how it can be implemented. Thanks. No, that I have not. That I have taken a non-linear regression model. I have developed, not any software. I have developed by myself. Means using this Excel, I have developed this non-linear regression equation.
One more question is: did you pre-process your data, or just?
No, pre-processing in the sense I have filled the gaps in the data. That only the pre-processing I have done. And in the data in Gulf of Mexico data, I've done month-wise data. Means for January the network was different. Likewise, 12 different models were there for different months. That pre-processing is there. In Indian data, actually, the data set was very small, which was available. So we have not tried for that in Indian data. But in Gulf of Mexico data, we have developed 12 months wise networks.
But every possibility exists that if you categorize the data into monsoon and non-season, and do the training separately, you may get. But the level of accuracy here, nothing without being there.
Based on the training and other means, even the algorithm may vary. With even lead time hour, it may vary. So it depends upon the trials.
For every month, there are different.
Yeah, for every month, four means 3rd, 6th, 12th, 24, four networks. For every month, four networks. So for 12 months, four, like that.
Yeah,
the architecture may be different, depending on the data.
You
are
using only LM?
In Indian data, LM was working well for all the early time hours. But when it came to Gulf of Mexico, it varied.
You have tried others?
Yeah, I have tried all the algorithms, nearly all the variations, neurons, all the various algorithms, everything. Try the best, I have reported. Radial basis also I have tried, ANFIS,
no, gradient.
Yeah, gradient descent I have tried. Means all possible which I could find, I have tried, and then I have reported the best one, which is applicable to my problem.
Okay.